everyone, my name is Varavan and welcome back to Danganronpa 2. So last episode, we kind of finally accepted that we were on a school trip, and then Monokuma came in and he messed it all up. So now he's telling us that in order to get off the island that we would have to kill someone and get away with it. Kind of like the first game, how you get out of the school. To raise my head from the He Handbook with a heavy sigh, I saw a dark courtyard at the hotel. It's not that dark. I sat on the bench, paralyzed with thought. Is he really going to make us do this? There's no way I could believe that this is now my reality. Even so, it was undeniably real. Oh, it was the Mono Beast. No matter how much I didn't want to believe it, the moment I experienced and felt it for myself, it became undeniably real. This is a reality that could not be more different from my normal school life. School, studying, exams, job hunting, going for walks, going to school, riding the train, lectures, that kind of daily life is no longer mine. Oh, night sky. As I looked up, I saw stars glimmering in the night, covering the sky like a sheet. They looked as if they were about to fall into my hands like fluttering snow. For the first time since I arrived at this island, instead of the night sky I'd grown accustomed to, I saw a night sky that was far too beautiful. As I stared blankly into that night sky, I suddenly imagined those words in my mind. The student who murders your classmate will be able to leave this island. When we were forced to hear those words, we just stood there silently. Nobody said a word, and eventually, everyone scattered and vanished. It led straight to the first night, a night so beautiful it enchanted me. And yet my heart was horribly upset. The kind of beauty was definitely far different than my usual daily life. And now we are in chapter 1. Destination Despair. The daily life.
Academy School Trip Executive Committee has an announcement to make. It is now 10 p.m. Nighttime can be confusing. If you're out at night and accidentally meet a killer, then it sucks to be you. But if you're worried about that and can't sleep, I've prepared a cottage on the hotel grounds for each of you. Every single one of you, please feel free to rest in your own rooms. However, before you go to bed, I strongly recommend you lock your doors. You never know who might be planning to kill you. Bye-bye.
Time to put more fear into your brains. That's ominous. A cottage, huh? Cottages. There we are. Guys, we kind of have our own little deck. Kazuichi's. Weird noise. Is flashing. Look, I got a TV, got a nice bed, there's a couch, there's a doll thing. As soon as I entered the cottage, I collapsed onto the bed. I screamed silently to myself, I buried my head into my arms. I didn't want to see anyone anymore, I just wanted to be alone forever. I had nobody I can trust, because even if I wanted to trust them, I don't know anything about them yet. The only person I could trust myself is myself. No, even I don't believe that. In truth, after I was forced to hear that dumb rule, you can't leave unless you kill someone, I realized there's a part of me that really wants to get off this island. The moment I let out a scream. A scream erupted from my mouth. Rushed from my mouth like water from a collapsed dam. Why me? Why do I have to go through this? I began to lose my voice and it faded entirely not long after. It followed with silence. Well, it's good you got that out, Hajime. No, not complete silence. I heard the faint sound of crashing waves in the distance and the background music. As if the waves were murmuring into my ears, this is no longer the world you knew. Once again, I buried my head in my arms. Why am I here? What am I even doing here? I forced my eyes shut. I wasn't tired or anything. I just wanted to sleep. If only for a short while. I wanted to put an end to it all. And if by chance I managed to wake up the next day, it'd be awesome if I was back to my normal life. With these meager expectations, I fell into a late sleep. Yay! You have an audience this time!
Danganronpa 2!
Those of you who purchased Danganronpa 2, goodbye despair, thank you very much. To those who are borrowing Danganronpa 2, goodbye despair from a friend. You always miss losing friends when you borrow other things, so you should buy your own copy just to be safe. Now that it's been a while since the main story started, I'll give you a keynote address right now. From now on, I promise you'll be charmed by this world. It genuinely deserves to be called a true game. Should you get excited, immerse yourself in the heart-throbbing action to your heart's content.
Now then, until the very end, please enjoy this game to the fullest!
Thanks, Monokuma. I'm awake.
Ahem! Hope Speak Academy School Trip Executive Committee has an announcement to make. Good morning, everyone! Looks like today is gonna be another perfect tropical day! Now then, let's show some enthusiasm and make sure to give it our all today!
So it definitely wasn't a dream after all. I was forced to acknowledge that yet again, which put me in a bad mood from the get-go. Guess for now I should go outside.
No, no, no!
You're not allowed to go out! Monokuma, why are you here?
No way!
Don't be so worried, I'm here for fun reasons.
Hey!
I want you to find my stuffed animals. I got ahead of myself and made too many, but I thought it'd be a waste to throw them away, so I've hid them all over the island. They're scattered all over various areas, so you just go right ahead and look for them all. Why do I have to do something like that?
Too bad!
As I said so, you can't say no. I've hidden one of them in the room, and I won't leave out till you find
it. Well?
Good luck! Selfish stuffed animal. It's up here.
Huh?
Oh.
I've been found.
Oh.
Well done.
Good job. I left you some mono coins. I'm so
Isn't
generous. These coins can be exchanged for fabulous items at the beach and the Rocket Punch Market. I put this stuff animals in other places too, so you rest and look for them. Find them all. Surprise, surprise. What? Never mind. I should just go. Look how nice. Oh, there's a bathroom. Ugh!
Huh?
Oh, it's just you. Don't scare me like that. I mean, the same for you.
Hey.
Did you see
Damn
them?
It.
They're not good. What the hell are they? Definitely not good. What are you talking about? The bridge, you know. Remember that bridge at the Central Island? Something happened to it? Shit, why the hell else would I be here?
Bad.
Those monsters are in front of the bridges. They're blocking them off.
Wrong.
They're not monsters. They're mono beasts. Oh my god, it's here! Kazuichi, I'm gonna need you to calm down for a sec.
So cool!
The mono beasts are guardians of Jabberwock Island. They're making sure you guys don't think about ignoring the progression by going to other islands. Monsters are gatekeepers, it'd be better if we don't get close to them. So annoying, I can't stand this anymore. Hey, get a grip, your face is getting weird.
Aw, man.
There's no way I can get a grip. We're gonna get eaten by monsters, there's no way I can enjoy vacation here now. What's with all the noise? Relax! It's not another monster. I came all this way to get you both, but if you're gonna call me a monster, you're here to get us?
Well, obviously.
I was told to come get you because we kept waiting and you two never showed up. Everyone is waiting at the hotel restaurant. Hurry up and join us. Everyone's waiting at the restaurant?
Damn it.
That's what she said. Whatever, man. I don't care. I don't care at all. I'm out of here. Where are you going? But I tried to save because we just ran away like lightning. Guess I'll head over to the restaurant. Alright. upstairs here. Hello, everyone. You're late talking to me. Where's Kazumichi? I thought you were together. He ran off somewhere.
Huh?
Where? Hey, I pretty much said he was running away, but... I mean, but where? There were two run anyway. What a weirdo.
However.
After what we witnessed yesterday, his behavior is understandable.
Huh?
You mean, did something happen yesterday? Yeah. Yes, a lot of things happened, and you pretending like you don't remember is not going to change that. I don't remember anything happening, and even if I did, it looked totally fake.
Understand.
Anyway. Not worth remembering at all. A lot easier to deal with all this if I could just deny it outright like
hey.
That. So why have you gathered us here? Not yet, not until Kazumichi arrives. Wait a sec, that means the reason you told to come here is...
Fighting!
Oui, apparently Monsieur Byakuya has something to tell us.
I'm gonna do it!
Obviously, we're here to discuss strategy for defeating that monster.
It's impossible!
No way we can fight that thing. I mean, it has heavy weapons and everything.
Show some spirit!
Anything is possible with the fighting spirit!
Let me tell you this.
He's so cool. A bold boast. However, let me give you some advice. The truly strong do not raise their voice so recklessly.
Hey, hey!
Let's start talking already. Perhaps some lame attempt to make us feel better or something.
Don't make me repeat myself.
When everyone is here, then we can start talking.
Jeez.
Fine, I'll bring Kazumichi myself then. Everyone here, I'll find him and bring him here, even if I have to tie him up.
Mm-hmm.
I'm jealous now, getting tied up by Miss Mihiro. Maybe I should run away too. Just kidding. Disgusting lawn.
That's fine.
Now, let's have breakfast while we
let's eat.
Okay. The moment he said that, he started wolfing down the pile of food in front of him. Where'd the food come from anyway? When I arrived this morning, it was already... They even have crab and shrimp!
Aww!
Such a pain to eat. I hate them as much as I hate Mikan's ugly, stuttering face. My ugly, stuttering face?
Gross!
That's it. That's the face right there.
Oh, why?
Why are you being so mean? I'm the kind of girl that bullies just love to torment, aren't you? Yeah, she's not nice. Just stop now.
Oh!
I got it. Tara prepared the food, right? Fortunately, it wasn't me. The food I make doesn't taste as bad as this does. This is bad? Tastes yummy to me.
No.
Yes. She has the right to an opinion, Taro. Compared to the world-class dishes I make, the dishes taste yummy would still be considered
nonsense!
And comparing them is even out of the question. Comparing my dishes to this lowly peasant food? How rude! I take it so personally.
I understand.
Say, if you guys ate my food, you wouldn't be able to control yourself.
Well done.
Let's just say your jaw wouldn't be the only thing that drops.
There's no mistaking it.
But your panties would drop, like the black thong Pico's wear, for example. Why do you know these things?
What did you say?
You creep, how do you know about that? You guessed correctly? He'd probably rummaged through their suitcases. Tara did not prepare this food, then you did this. Could have been Monokuma? Is it safe to eat food cooked by something like that? Why I'm tasting it for poison to make sure it's safe for consumption. You don't need to eat that much to check for poison.
Hey.
Okay, thanks for waiting.
You
I brought it.
Straighten
up a little more. Shouldn't a man like you be embarrassed to walk like that?
Man.
Oh, don't pull, you're gonna rip my sleeves. Hey, y'all are in a bad situation. Like, leave me alone. Even though you look all flashy, you're actually a big coward. Are you gonna be okay? People like you are usually the first victim, you know.
Ah.
Just wanna go home already. Oh dear.
Ah!
What?
No.
What? Mikan!
I tripped!
Can you even call that tripping?
How in the world did you end up in such a compromising position after tripping?
Well, it certainly makes me happy. I'm very happy right now.
Oh, I'm so embarrassed. Please help me. Aww. She looks so adorable when she's embarrassed.
Help the woman!
It's so moe. I'm practically snorting with joy. We should help her up.
Yes, thank you, Mihiro. hero, and thank you for blocking her sensitive area from the screen.
Are you okay?
My head is throbbing a bit, but I'm okay. Your head's definitely not okay. Theon, just a clumsy girl. That ball of her must have been a magic trick or something. Everyone's here right now, right? Let's get going. I'm getting sleepy. You're right, though I'm not quite ready to stop eating breakfast, I should begin my talk. It's finally starting, it took way too long. You had to wait for him! He's all good now. Cuffed pants. What?
Listen.
I was trying to click him. First, I have a question for you all. That Monokuma thing ordered us to kill each other. So under these strange circumstances, what do you think we need right now? Who knows? Get to the point.
Don't make me repeat myself.
Get to the point. You better hurry up and answer my question.
Huh?
What do we need? We need food and sleep, obviously, right?
No!
No, you forgot to pooping. I forgot that he's super in it. These answers are a good appetite, a good night's sleep, and a good shit. Does anyone have a real answer?
Perhaps.
Would it be a bond? Bond?
I...
What I believe. As long as the Ultimates work together, there's nothing we can't do.
It's obvious.
You'll all be able to create a hope that can overcome any despair. That's why if we want to escape this island, we need to promise each other that we'll work together.
Both.
Wow, he said that with a straight face. How is he not embarrassed? Just as I figured. Kind of lame, huh?
However.
He does have a point. Must be why Monokuma's enforcing a rule that'll cause us to be suspicious of each other.
I see.
That was a pretty good answer. Since it's impossible to face our enemies as individuals, under these circumstances we must fight as a group. We need to achieve that solidarity is not something that's easygoing and optimistic as a bond.
Huh?
Then what?
Listen.
We need right now is a disciplined leadership, provided by an unmistakable
I
leader.
See.
Even sport teams need captains after
Great
all.
Choice.
I shall accept the position.
Hmm.
Shall wrap up the introduction and move on to the main question.
Hey!
Wait a second.
What? Jeez.
What did you say? I don't care how you excuse it. You're being too forceful. Deciding to lead her all on your own? Why does it have to be you anyway?
Not possible.
It's more fit to lead other than me. I'm the ultimate affluent prodigy of the Togami household, destined to stand above all others.
What are you saying?
My family is super rich. Yeah, that doesn't mean anything. I'm telling you that attitude of yours is too forceful.
Wait.
Hero, please wait. It's true, Byakuya may be a little forceful, but given our current situation, I believe it's a leader's duty under circumstances like this to be forceful to a certain degree. It'd be true, but if we just need someone who can lead people, then even Sonya can. Oh, perish the thought. I'm merely a figurehead.
Hey.
So the royal family in her country doesn't do anything either. Just like England. Well, you must have the qualities of a leader if you can accept the role under these circumstances. If everyone's okay with it, I'm okay with it too.
It's all clear now.
Because we made our decision. Don't worry, as long as I'm the leader, I won't let anyone be
I will guide you all.
That much I promise. So reliable. Well, he's certainly a little nicer than he is than the first game. True's reliable. I'm a little surprised. I didn't think he was the type of guy to say something like that. I expected the ultimate affluent prodigy to look down on us like we're bugs or something. Let's move on to the topic at hand for real this time. I have something to show you all.
Follow me.
So Jaguar Park is Central Island. Come follow me. After saying so bluntly, Byakuya turned and left the restaurant, stomping his feet along the way. Just as I thought, he sure is forceful. It may have been a mistake in choosing him as our leader. Though everyone made similar complaints, they all followed Byakuya out of the restaurant. Aren't you guys going?
Let's go, Jumpy, Magazine, Sandy, Champy!
My four Doc Davis are destruction. Let us venture to the end of the Jabberwock Park. You just shout, hurry up and go already. Be nice to him. Okay, he's cool. I'm gonna go this way, just in case there's Monokuma around. Do you see any bears? No? Better hear probably Byakuya said Jabba Rock Park, I believe.
Oh,
I've arrived. Skinny people, you're awfully slow. Seems you are just too fast for us. Or except that a fatso like him to move so fast.
What?
Maybe it's all muscle. You don't know. It's supposed to be here. Here, really?
Such ignorance.
If you haven't noticed it yet, then it was right to dismiss you all as idiots. Oh my! That's a problem. Oh dear. Like the timer is in Persona 5. It's like a clock, but something seems off. It's counting down.
What's going on?
Is this here the last time?
No.
I'm pretty sure it wasn't. Found it this morning when I was exploring the island one more time. It's unknown when it was actually placed.
It appears.
Monokuma must have placed this object. What does the countdown even mean?
Aww.
I have no clue. Once again, it appears something has appeared that I don't understand, but it's got nothing to do with me because I refuse to believe this is happening.
Hold on!
It better not be a bomb.
Are you kidding me?
A bomb? It
not
looks
possible.
Like one. They wanted to blow up the island, they would. Wanted to blow up there, and then they could have done so by now. There's no need for a countdown. What are they counting down? It's a mystery.
Right?
A mysterious mystery, isn't it?
Yeah.
Monami!
What?
Why are you here? I heard everyone talking while I was patrolling, so I came over. Not that. Didn't Monokuma kill you?
I see.
Oh, that's why you were surprised. You don't have to worry about that. I can never die.
It appears you cannot escape.
You must be an undead abomination risen from the foulest depths of the netherworld, my black magic. Do you want me to make you my thrall?
Hey.
Hanami's a mechanical stuffed animal, right? Doesn't that mean she can't die in the first place? Now that you mention it, she'd only need like a spare or something. A spare? What a mean thing to say. However, you've arrived at the perfect time. There's something I want to ask.
Come on.
What is the meaning behind this timer and this countdown? Answer me. Countdown? What is this? I'm sorry, I don't know what this is.
Hey.
You really don't know?
I'm sorry.
I don't really have a grasp of what Monokuma's up to.
Huh?
You don't know even though you're Monokuma's little sister?
That's wrong.
I'm not my brother's little sister. Set the rule or not, which is it?
Alrighty!
Let's all do our best. Let's kick evil Monokuma off this island. If you don't know what the countdown is for, you're useless to us. Get lost. Let's together?
I said get lost.
Yeah!
You're so mean! She's just trying to help. Perhaps you're trying to be good. Perhaps you're being a little too harsh. I'm starting to feel sorry. Miss Sonia, may I call you Miss Sonia? No, I insist I call you that. There's no need to feel sorry for that thing. She's obviously working with
Monokuma. Hey, bastard.
Who cares about the stuffed animal? More importantly, what the hell is that clack? Looks ominous, doesn't it? Who put that object here, and how did they do it in just one night? I can't imagine. Which means it doesn't make any sense. Also, it's deadly. However, that's not all that's unimaginable. The island's full of mysteries we can't even begin to imagine. For example, how were the 16 of us brought here to this island? Trying to think about that since it's been bugging me too, but he's right, that is a mystery. There's more. Why is Jabberwock Island, which is known for being a popular resort destination, now an uninhabited island? There's no signs of tourists or even citizens on the island. Is something like that even possible?
This, too, must be the will of causality.
All civilizations are destined to collapse. Nothing begets existence, and existence begets nothing. Perhaps.
You are right.
Society is much like fruit. Once it matures, it is inevitable that it will eventually rot. As the economy grows, the private sector stagnates as the elders and bureaucrats grow more powerful. As time passes, this power becomes the status quo and crushes the seeds of any possible
that is
such a sad truth. I don't understand that at all, but all that, but I feel like the situation here is somewhat different.
So...
maybe the Mono Beast killed everyone on this island?
What?
That's how it became uninhabited?
Certainly possible.
Possibility, but we don't know that for sure. Mystery remains a mystery, it seems. Are you okay, Bookie? Everything here is just full of mysteries. Right, it's mysteries on top of mysteries. However, since these mysteries are overlapping with one another, I doubt some no-name group is behind this. What are you trying to say?
So, in other words...
the situation we're in is undeniably the work of some enormous organization. Enormous organization? Monami, Monokuma, and the Monobeast, they're all machines that require major technical skill to operate.
Are we screwed?
Plus, they need a ton of funding. There's no way those things were just made for the hell of it.
In other words...
organization might be controlling these machines and monitoring the islands with those cameras. Could those fiends be hiding on this island?
Not possible.
They're probably running this from somewhere else, somewhere safe.
Oh?
Where would that be? I don't know. No mistake, the enormous organization is behind all this. Big organization. Can't imagine what kind of people they
In
could
other
be.
Words...
bad people, because they're trying to get you to kill each other. There's my Togami Corporation, Sony's Novacelic Kingdom, the Kuzuru Clan. Definitely would have to be an organization as powerful as one of the groups. I'm used to being mistrusted.
Hey!
I don't care about you or the Kuzuru Clan, but I won't allow you to doubt Miss Sonya. Miss Sonya's a hot blonde princess. There's a sharp distinction between her and me.
Yes, yes.
Shut up already, loser.
Whoa!
Loser, you're talking about me?
Yeah.
Obviously, when you're flashing clothes, you just want to stand out because you're actually a loser. Must be hard making your living in the lame-ass loser industry. Are you serious just now about this being related to your family and Sony's and such? I'm just using them as an example. I'm not saying they have anything to do with this. True. Certainly we're up against a huge organization, right?
Whoever.
If such an organization exists, why would they make us go through something like this?
Anyway.
Whatever. How long are we going to keep talking about this? Why don't we talk about something more realistic? Our enemy's purpose is still unknown. As long as we find out who's behind this, we'll learn
their purpose. So, in other words...
So what we must do now is to find out who our enemy is. If we do that, we'll be that much closer to a breakthrough. Luckily, according to the e-handbook, we're free to explore this island. There would definitely be a clue about the enemy on the island somewhere. Let's
I'm gonna do it!
Let's get this crap done. What are we looking for?
Hey.
Kane, were you even listening? We need to find clues that'll tell us who our enemy is.
Fine.
No problem. No matter how large this organization may be, they will not be able to stand up
Go
against
by
us.
Four dark
they are destined
devas
to fall and turn to ash
at
the might of my four dark devas of destruction.
Wow!
Hamsters just came out of your skull. They're so adorable.
What?
Adorable, you say?
Thank you.
Oh, look at his face.
Oh my my!
Pretty happy about that, huh? Guy talking to Miss Sonya all casually. I'm definitely gonna beat the crap out of him later. No, you're not. He's the ultimate breeder. He deals with animals all the time. He probably knows how to take down an aggressive person. In this tense situation, we all need to be a lot more cautious, and yet I'm relieved that everyone is in such high spirits. It's strange, but I feel like I can rely on them. This must be what it means to have the confidence of an ultimate. Am I confident enough to call myself one of them? Man, I still can't remember. What talent am I supposed to have?
Listen.
Let me just say this. There's no time to think about something as foolish as killing each other. You must do what you have to do. Observe, speculate, recognize, comprehend. Even if it seems impossible, just persevere. But most importantly, follow my lead. I'll make sure to return you all to your normal.
This is your leader's order.
Understand? It's like totally awesome. That right hand of his is so plump. I've got the perfect nickname for him. Ham Hands.
Ham Hands?
I never thought I'd see the day when someone called me something like that. Why aren't you getting mad?
Naturally.
Why aren't you getting mad at something as petty as that? She appeared to be directly thought of a nickname. There's nothing dishonest about a name like that. Perhaps have always yearned for this, though it may seem ironic for me to realize that in this particular situation. He's totally monologuing right now. Maybe he likes
such
the idea
talk.
Of getting a nickname. Don't worry about it, I was talking to myself just now. I really don't get it, but I guess this guy isn't just some overconfident narcissistic jerk after all. Despite our situation, he's mysteriously calm. He might just be a reliable person after
all.
Maybe we should listen to Byakuya and not waste our energy thinking about pointless things. It's true we're not in the best situation, but it's also not the worst. Because we're not alone. We have friends we can count on to support each other. That sounds so lame. I knew it. I was thinking to myself how lame I sound for saying that. Friends, huh? Till now, I've never really thought about friendship. This sort of thing seemed embarrassing. I never would have thought about it in this situation. It's more like because of this situation. In the end, we never solved mysteries of the ominous countdown. But without losing heart, we all went back to the hotel. Leaving you and your friends, huh? It'd be difficult to believe in them right away, but it'd be nice if it could happen a little at a time. I'm starting to think like that. Doesn't that show I'm making good progress? No reason to hold up in my room and start blinking in space. Since there's time, I think it'd be a great idea if I went ahead and talked to everyone. Free time! Present, yep. We know about this. Free time by resting in cottage bed. Don't recommend it if you want to continue to destroy right away. Alright. Well, we will start that next time. Hopefully we'll figure out some clues about who's holding us here. And maybe even get further into the story. So thank you so much for watching. Go ahead and subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time.